Hi students, namaste. This is Arjun Gupta from St. Joseph Degree College. In this session, we are supposed to discuss regarding to branch banking system. Banks play a significant role in the overall development of a country. There has been a rapid growth of banking organizations in different countries. Different types of banking systems have come into existence with the development of economy. The banking system differs from economy to economy and country to country. Every country has its own banking system. Banking systems are broadly classified on various grounds like volume of operations, business pattern, and area of activity. There are different types of banking systems: unit banking, branch banking, chain banking, group banking, universal banking, and investment banking. In the previous topic, we have discussed regarding to unit banking. Now we are supposed to discuss regarding to branch banking system in detail. Now let us see the definition of branch banking. A branch bank is a banking corporation that directly owns two or more banking agencies in the form of branches. That means if a bank it is having more than one branch, then it is supposed to called as branch banking system. Branch banking is still an integral part of Indian banking system, as most Indians still believe in cash transaction and prefer to visit banks in person for routine banking operations. Bank branches are the face of the banks where customers can visit and talk to the officials for getting better insight into new policies, investment schemes, other banking services, etc. On top of it, the personal touch in every service leaves a great impact on the minds of customers. However, banking in India has changed its facts and ways of doing business over the years, especially after the onslaught of technology and its manifestation. People have started to drift towards latest modes of banking like e-banking, mobile banking, etc. But the acceptance percentage is low as compared to other countries. These innovations hold promising future, and branches have to continually evolve to remain relevant in coming times. Branch banking makes management more responsive and efficient over centralized banking operations. Also, the risk is well spread across the branches and no single office has to suffer. This helps banks to offer more securities and investment options to its customers. Also, due to wide geographic spread, a broader customer base, deposits used in one branch can be used profitably as loans or investments in other branches. This type of banking system can easily reach people in backward areas. There are some negative points too, which branch banking system faces, like delay in decision making due to limited power of branches influenced by local political leaders or administration, etc. The Banking Regulation Act 1949 defines a branch office of a banking company as a place where bank deposits are received, checks cashed, money lent, any or all banking services are carried out. These exclude the bank call centers, as they are typically calling facilities which do not have any customer interaction. A branch will include all full-fledged specialized branch, a satellite or mobile office, an extension counter, administrative office, control office, service branch, credit card center, etc. Branch banking has a lot of importance in India, as it makes banking possible for people living in rural and remote areas. This is true source of inclusive growth. Branch banking makes management more responsive and effective over centralized banking operations. Also, the risk is well spread across the branches and no single office has to suffer. This helps banks to offer more securities and investment options to its customers. Also, due to the widespread geographical spread and a broader customer base, deposits in one branch can be used profitably as loans or investments in other branches. This type of banking system can easily reach people in backward areas. There are some negative points too, which branch banking faces, like delay in decision making due to limited powers of branches influenced by local political leaders or administration, etc. Now let us discuss the advantages and disadvantages in branch banking system. First of all, let us see what are the advantages of branch banking system in detail. There are so many advantages of branch banking system. Let us see one by one. Branch banking leads to economies of large scale operation. Branch banking system possesses the advantage of large scale operation, such as division of labor and specialization. The entire working of banks might be divided into different sections, such as foreign exchange section, agriculture section, etc. For each section, specialized staff can be appointed. With greater resources and better training facilities, they can appoint skilled people to cater to the needs of banking services. Thus, banking system makes more possible a higher quality of management. Branch banking system is also having a greater advantage in economy of reserve. Branch banking ensures economy of cash reserve. Each bank is dependent not only on its own reserve but also on the total of all branches, and hence in times of need one branch can draw upon the resources of the other bank. In other words, each branch can manage its affairs with low cash reserve. Branch banking system has a chance of spreading of risk. In the branch banking system, each bank has a group of branches scattered far and wide, and each branch has its own deposits and assets. This diversification of assets is the most important advantage of this system. By diversifying resources, they invest in different kinds of assets in different industries in several places. So, in times of crisis in a place, the other branches are not affected much, and the profits of one branch can neutralize the loss of other branch. For instance, when depreciation set in one cotton industry, British banks in other cotton industries were incurring heavy losses, but their losses were offset by gains in other areas and there was no general banking crisis. Branch banking system has remittance facilities. Remittance of funds from one place to another can be provided at cheaper rate under branch banking system. This is possible because inter-branch indebtedness can be more easily adjusted than inter-bank indebtedness. Branch banking reducing disparities in interest rate. The branch banks increase the mobility of funds between various regions and bring about uniformity in the rate of interest over a wide area. Funds are transferred from the region where they are plenty and demand for it is low to the regions where it is scarce and demand is high. In both the areas, money supply is brought to equilibrium, and so the interest rate tends to be uniform. Branch banking system have a greater stability. The branches command great financial resources. They can meet the financial needs of a large number of customers. Besides, they can withstand depression and meet an emergency. In branch banking, enhanced profitability can be possible. The lending limit of branch bank is greater. People in an area may demand in excess of the deposit of the branch. The excess demand could be met by transferring money from other branches. The free movement of funds, which is possible through branch banking, will add to profitability of banking operations. In branch banking, quick expansion of branches can be happen. Under unit banking system, starting a new bank requires much time and resources, but a branch bank can organize its new branches more quickly and economically. In branch banking, clearing of checks are made very easy. Clearing of checks is comparatively easy than unit bank. Checks deposited at a branch can be sent to the office in the city where there is a clearing house and cleared in customary way. Clearing of checks involves greater complication and expenses in unit banking system. Finally, in branch banking, effective central bank control can be happen. The central bank of a country can have effective control over the branch banks. It is easy for the central bank to regulate the functioning of a limited number of banks having a number of branches. With little difficulty, the central bank can issue directions and supervise the branch banks. These are the advantages of branch banking system. Now, let us see the disadvantages in branch banking system. The first and foremost disadvantage of branch banking system was difficulties of management, supervision and control. Since there are hundreds of branches of a bank under this system, management, supervision and control becomes more inconvenient and difficult. There are possibilities of mismanagement in branches. Branch managers may misuse their position and misappropriate funds. There is great scope for fraud. Thus, there are possibilities of fraud and irregularities in the financial management of the bank. In branch banking, there is a lack of initiative. The branches of the bank under this system suffer from a complete lack of initiative on important banking problems confronting them. No branch of the bank can take decision on important problems without consulting the head office. Consequently, the branches of the banks find themselves unable to carry on banking activities in accordance with the requirements of local situation. This makes the banking system rigid and inelastic in its functioning. This also leads to red tapeism, which means official delay. In branch banking system, monopolistic tendencies can be seen over. Branch banking encourages monopolistic tendency in this banking system. A few big banks dominate and control the whole banking system of the country through their branches. This can lead to concentration of resources in the hands of a small number of persons. Such a monopoly power is a source of danger to the community, which aims at a socialistic pattern of society. In bank branching, regional imbalances can be seen over. Under the branch banking system, the financial resources collected in the smaller and backward regions are transferred to the bigger industrial centers. This encourages regional imbalance in the country. In branch banking, continuance of non-profitable branches can be seen. Under branch banking, the weak and unprofitable branches continue to operate under the protection cover of strong and profitable branches. In branch banking, unnecessary competition can be seen. Branch banking is delocalized banking. Under branch banking system, the branches of different banks get concentrated at certain places, particularly in big towns and cities. This gives rise to unnecessary and unhealthy competition among them. The branches of the competing banks try to tempt customers by offering extra inducements and facilities to them. This naturally increases the banking expenditure. In branch banking, we are supposed to have more expenses than occurrence of unit bank. Branch banking system is much more expensive than the unit banking system. When a bank opens a number of branches at different places, then there arises the problem of coordinating their activities with others. This necessitates the employment of expensive staff by the bank. Students, these are the advantages and disadvantages of branch banking system. Thus, branch banking system as well as unit banking system suffers from defects and drawbacks. But the branch banking system is on the whole better than the unit banking system. In fact, the branch banking system has proved more suitable for backdraw and developing countries like India. Branch banking is very popular and successful in India. A comparison between unit banking and branch banking is essentially a comparison between small scale and large scale operations. I hope you have understood a lot and enjoyed this.